and that's not working at all. Wait. This is like really shoddy.
This could be better. This is our intro, and there's some weird kid screaming behind us.
I'm jerking some dudes off. Jared. Hey, Jared. Hey, it's Justin. Hey, it's your old garage. There's Jason eating pizza.
Hey, I was just eating pizza a second ago.
Yeah.
Woo!
Chee-boom.
Chee-boom, boom, boom, chee-boom.
Chee-boom,
chee-boom, boom. Welcome to Couch Co-op. I'm Ian.
I'm Jason.
And we're in fucking Italy.
Pisa. You can
Pisa.
Probably tell by that.
There's a giant erection.
Yeah.
Behind Jason's head.
Thing leaning behind me.
And we thought we'd do a little impromptu couch co-op. And what have you been playing, Jason? We're just going to focus on you,
been,
Jason.
I have been... Oh,
no, grazie, God. Grazie, no, grazie. You're on, you're grazie. No, we don't.
Seriously.
No, what? Oh, man, you're fucking our shit up. No, no, no.
These fucking vendors.
No, vendors, no. Thank you, though. You're like, what's his name in Destiny? Who sells the shit? Zer.
Zer.
Fucking Zer. Yeah. Fucking yeah. Zer.
Zer, all up in our shit.
Talking about Destiny. Destiny 2.
Yeah, Destiny 2.
You played the beta.
Fuck yeah, I played the beta.
How was it?
I tore through that shit. All right, so, couple of pointers. One, it's incredibly obvious that they have taken all of the notes from the community over the last few years and done drastic improvements to the narrative. I'm a little bit worried about, like, in that initial story mission, you actually had NPCs playing with you in the fight. And I'm a little bit worried that when you start doing the grind and getting into the repetition, that, like, that's going to be stupid, that's going to be boring. But if
right,
you're, if
when
you're just
when you play that mission over and over again.
For us 1% of Destiny players who play every single level 100 times, those parts might get really shitty. But for the people who are casual Destiny players, 99% of you who are only going to play everything maybe 1 to 5 times, I think it's going to be a drastic improvement.
So I read an article, like, was it really that important that they increased the story in Destiny?
Yeah, yeah, because that was the number one thing that Destiny got hit for.
Right.
Like, that was the biggest criticism of Destiny was that its story was lacking. And it's not like the world itself was lacking, because if you grinded it out enough to get the Grimoire cards and actually read them, it ended up being one of the most in-depth and compelling video game worlds ever, with a really intense story. But that wasn't in game, and
right,
they are clearly changing that because that's what most people want.
All right, gameplay. I want to know about gameplay. I've heard that it's a little slower.
It is slower, and the thing that I'm really upset about is I was playing the Titan in Crucible, and I couldn't Titan skate. I was doing that tap to tap tap, and my guy didn't go any faster. And I'm a little worried about closing the distance on people. I'm gonna have to relearn some shit.
Well, me personally, you know, they announced the fucking bundle. You wanted to talk about that a little bit, just briefly. You wanted to, like,
motherfucker,
they didn't announce it at E3, but just a couple weeks before the beta, oh, we got a bundle coming out, motherfuckers.
Yeah, so I specifically did not pre-order Destiny 2 for months because I would not pre-order it until after E3, because I was really hoping that they were going to announce a Destiny 2 PS4 Pro bundle, and they didn't, and I was like, okay, I guess there's not one coming. So I dropped the $90. I bought the Everything Destiny package, really excited about it, and I bought it on the PlayStation Network. It's not like I It's not like I did that shit at GameStop where I can just go in and switch my pre-order from one thing to another.
Right.
Like, the PlayStation Network made me click a button that said, this is not refundable, you understand that, right?
Right.
Yeah, so Thanks.
Well, but I'm gonna go home and pre-order the bundle, and I'm gonna get that budgetary breakdown. I mean, it's quite like a significant discount, like $40-$50. Yeah. I mean, depending on how you look at it.
But for the first time ever, as the world's biggest Bungie defender, I can now get on board with saying, thanks for fucking me, Bungie.
All right.
It finally happened to me, too. All right.
Couch co-op, all we ever talk about is Destiny. We got us to talk about some other shit.
Hey.
What else are you doing? VR? You want to do VR or you want to do Switch?
What do you want to talk about? Okay. I'm loving Switch. It's the first handheld console I've loved, but I don't want to talk about that right now.
Don't want to talk about it. All right.
No, I want to talk about Final Fantasy XIV Stormblood.
Oh!
Stormblood just
came out.
Oh
my god.
It's rocking a 90 Metacritic. We loved that
shit. Oh, we did. We loved
that
shit a lot.
3 years ago.
Enjoyed the shit out of that game.
Final Fantasy XIV is back, ladies and gentlemen.
I started the best story in it, that version, supposedly.
Yeah. I logged 360 hours into that game 3.5 years ago. Reached max level character, was ready to let it go, and I saw those Metacritic scores, and I was like, oh.
And we got a couple friends
go back to an MMO? And
we got a couple of friends that can see playing that, though. Like, Dallas keeps playing that.
Yeah.
I have someone else that plays it, too.
I paid money to switch to Dallas's server, so I'm playing with Dallas now.
That's cool.
But I am, three and a half years later, I am balls deep into Final Fantasy XIV again.
I've always wanted to go back.
I've completely fallen in love with it.
So what makes it so good, though? Tell me why. Because I want to come back, but I don't know why. Why spend the money?
Well, all of the things that made it good to begin with. Right. The way that it was a compelling but relaxing style of gameplay. Like, as a serious Destiny player, I love the fact that Destiny is, like, grindy and gagey and deep. But Final Fantasy XIV manages to be that level of addicting and engaging while being relaxing. When you're playing Final Fantasy XIV, you feel completely chill. Yeah, I know.
It's beautiful.
Yeah. Hey, check it out. It's a
fucking beautiful church over here, and
yeah,
shit.
It's the. No.
That's where we are.
Yeah,
we're standing
in front of the Leaning Tower.
Somewhat influenced, you know, I'm sure this shit influenced Final Fantasy, if you think about it. Like, some of this, like, architecture in their games and shit.
But even more so the church. So, I'm going to take a break from video games to tell you guys that even though the Leaning Tower of Pisa is very famous, the cathedral in Pisa is one of the earliest examples of Romanesque architecture and is highly influential in some of the most amazing buildings in the world. It's right there, and like, no one's paying attention to it. Everyone's standing in front of this going, fucking dicks.
Pay attention.
There's amazing architecture.
It's calling you out, motherfuckers. You fucking
just
pretentious
to the left of this.
Cocksuckers.
Well, I'm probably the pretentious person here.
No, so we got Destiny 2, we got Final Fantasy 14 expansion. We don't have a lot of VR. You gotta cram it in here. I don't know how much time we have.
All right.
My phone's gonna like crash and be like, fuck you.
I'm gonna do this super quick.
VR's awesome.
Farpoint is fucking amazing.
It is.
VR will change your life.
It will.
Star Trek Bridge Crew is incredibly underrated. If you like Star Trek at all, you need to jump on that shit. And the most underrated VR game that is in existence right now is Tethered. I don't understand why everyone isn't talking about Tethered. It's sublime.
All right. Jason, other thing coming up. 100th episode of the podcast. What do you want to tell about? Talk to the boys back home.
Hey, guys. Really enjoyed watching Aaron eating all those balls. You guys should make one of my beers for the podcast.
We need 8-Bit Brewing to send us some beers, and then you can sponsor us.
It's summertime. You've got the Ocarina Lime recipe. Bust that shit out.
8-Bit Brewing. You have a website yet?
Yeah.
What is it?
8bitbrewing.fi.
Oh, there you go. Great beer, video game related. Awesome. We're in Italy.
Yeah, we're in Italy.
We're snugging it up.
Yeah. We spent the day on the Italian Riviera. It was fucking lovely.
Special couch co-op to you guys. We love you. Awesome. Spending time with Jason.
All right. Let's go drink more.
I'm Ian.
I'm Jason.
Couch Co-op. Peace.
Boop-a-ba-doop. Boop-a-ba-doop. Boop-a-ba-doop-a-doop-a-doop-a-doop. Couch Co-op!